Yeah, I know it get hard out here sometimes and you feel like giving up, but if you woke up this morning, that means you got a chance and you need to do something with it. Licking shots in the air cause we made it. Waving shots in the air cause we faded. Life beat you down, got you a little jaded. Thought you found your soulmate, now you're separated. Rolling up your sleeves and making a resolution. Trying to buy a crib and hoping you get approved. This year I hope you get everything that you want. And look how far we come in a matter of 12 months. That's right, we starting it over, we starting today. No excuses, we out here. Hey, 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 hey. Come yeah. on.
It's a new year, it's a new day. It's a new chance for us to find our way. It's a new year, it's a new.
This hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show, baby. Let's go. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I've been drinking. I get filthy when that liquor get it to me. I've been thinking. Why can't I keep my fingers off it, baby? I want you, nah, nah. Why can't I keep my fingers off it, baby? I want you, nah, nah. Cigars on ice. Feeling like an animal with these cameras all in my grill. Flashing lights. You got me pity, 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 baby, I want you, nah, nah. Can't keep your eyes off my pity, daddy, I want you, nah, nah. Drunk in love, I want you.
All right, welcome back to the show. Happy Woman Wednesday to all of the ladies out there. Yes, sir. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Just reading some of these messages in the chat on Spreaker.com. From Mr. J Twice. Okay, it looks like a new name in the chat. Welcome to the Doug Stewart Show. Welcome to the Doug Stewart Show chat room, Miss J Twice. You know what? No, I think J Twice has been in before. Miss J Twice. Let me take a look at Miss J Twice's profile pic. Yeah, she just changed her name a little bit. Frequent listener to the show. Happy Woman Wednesday to you, Miss J Twice. She says, Doug, they can maybe hire David Griffin, and maybe LeBron will join the Knicks. Wow, that would be a great move. Now you playing chess. It's funny. This kind of goes back to what I was saying earlier about Phil Jackson. It felt like he was doing the job with blindfolds on, with a blindfold on. In the last 15 minutes, we've come up with several ideas, several attainable ideas. Two in particular. When the Big Apple Bastard called the show and talked about them hiring Mark Jackson, I think they can do that right now. Like, I think they can have a deal in place by the end of the day for Mark Jackson. It just makes too much sense, all right? And then also, this would be a great thing as well. You remember Phil Jackson kind of pissed LeBron off with all of the trashing of Carmelo Anthony, throwing him under the bus or whatever in the media. And LeBron kind of voices displeasure about that whole narrative. And LeBron has come out in full support of David Griffin, as being the GM of the Cleveland Cavaliers. So he gets fired. LeBron sends out this tweet, says, we're going to miss you, all that you did. It sounds like he's got an affinity for David Griffin. Yeah, that's a great move. The Stewies in the last 15 minutes have done a better job of being the Knicks GM than Phil Jackson's done in 3 years. Good one. I agree. Now, it doesn't mean that LeBron will leave and come to New York. I think it would give you a better chance than you have right now. And that would be cool as talk out there as well. I've seen, you know, these analysts, these insiders so-called, talking about how, you know, all of these guys want to play together. Carmelo, LeBron, Chris Paul, Dwayne Wade, and that would be one of, like, their fantasies, per se. Yeah, I mean, you'd have a better chance to get LeBron to come to New York if you hired David Griffin. I agree with that 100%. And thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? What you want to talk about?
Doug Stewart, man. What's going on? It's Dollars and Cents, baby.
Dollars and Cents. Good morning, brother. How you doing?
I'm doing well, man. How you doing, man?
I'm great. What you got for me?
Here's the thing, man. Hey, the Knicks still are depleted of talent. You know, even if they get the GM or former GM of Cleveland, you still got to acquire talent. They had a horrific draft. They could have picked a kid Monk, and they drafted some European point guard.
Yeah.
So LeBron's only got X amount of years, and do I think he's going to leave Cleveland? Yeah. But if he goes to the Lakers, which, hey, not an issue, are they going to beat Golden State, Doug? I mean, you know, minus next year, he'll be his 16th year. What do you think about that, bro?
Yeah, I mean, like I said to the Big Apple Bastard, I mean, the whole thing about Mark Jackson makes sense. Miss J twice just gave a good thought about the David Griffin. But you got to remember, all of these guys that you're thinking that are going to come to New York now because they got Phil out of there, all of these guys pretty much are at the end of their rope. They're older.
Yep.
So, I mean, there's a lot of things at play, but I don't see all of that coming together for them. Getting rid of Phil, I think, is a good start, though.
It definitely is a good start. It's just kind of crazy, man, that they gave the guy $24 million when, honestly, he could have got rid of him, like, what, a month ago, and not had to pay the cat $24 million.
Yeah.
So it's just one bungle after another. As far as with Cleveland, you know I'm a big Cleveland guy. I think LeBron's gone. I don't have an issue with it. If he leaves, he leaves. If he goes to the L.A., it's still, I'm not sure if they got enough to get it done. But what I think is smart is, from what I'm hearing, is that your Lakers now that they, may get Klay Thompson. And that makes more sense for the Lakers. When you look at it from a talent standpoint and not giving up anything, is to get Klay as a free agent and Paul George, you know, versus an aging LeBron who's going to want to do everything his way. So I appreciate everything, man. You're doing a great job. Keep doing your thing, brother, and I'm gone.
I appreciate the call, my man, Dollars and Cents. He called 404-382-0338. I also have read a couple of things about the possibility of trying to bring Klay Thompson, and that's almost one of those things that makes so much sense because he's from California, because his daddy played for the Lakers, because his daddy right now is a color analyst for the team, because he's in California right now, because he's on a stacked team where he lost a lot of his shots last year because of Kevin Durant. I'll wait and see if that happens, but I'm not betting on something like that to happen. But, yes, as a Laker fan, would I be tremendously excited to have Klay Thompson and Paul George? Yeah. Will it happen? I don't know. I wouldn't bet on it right now. But, yeah. They getting rid of Phil Jackson, man, is actually a pretty good thing. From Fail Pay, he says, speaking of baby steps, the Lakers missed on the number two pick, Russell. But Doug is fully convinced that the Lakers are a mess, just like the Knicks. We may have missed the end of the traditional powerhouses of the NBA and not have known it. No, the Lakers are going to be back. The Lakers are struggling right now. I acknowledge that. I mean, there's nothing to really acknowledge. That's clear. That's obvious that the Lakers have been struggling right now. But let's just say this. That's just over the last couple of years. The Lakers hadn't struggled, you know, for the last 43 like the New York Knicks have. From Big Apple Bastion, once again, in the chat on Spreaker.com. He says, Mark Jackson, coach, LeBron, Melo, Porzingis, Paul, and George in the backcourt. Chumps, not one, not two, but a three-peat with that lineup. and I also have some swamp land in Oakley, South Carolina I want to sell you. Yeah. From Fell Pay, he says, before the Hawks, Bab, but the Hawks just won a playoff season a year ago. When the last time the Knicks won a playoff series? When's the last time the Knicks won a playoff series? Long, long time. A very, very long time. You know, it's another good little side story to this whole New York Knicks, Phil Jackson separation. Is that Phil Jackson now officially he's the worst GM in New York Knicks history, where a lot of people wanted to lay a lot of the blame on the problems that are going on in New York on Isaiah Thomas. Now Isaiah Thomas is looking like, I don't know, freaking Red Auerbach. And the annals of New York Knicks team president slash GMs, Isaiah Thomas looks like freaking a Red Auerbach right now. The black Red Auerbach compared to Phil Jackson. And the just debauchery that's going on in that organization for the last 3 years of his tenure. I mean, I absolutely love it. I absolutely love it. This is a great day. Like, there's a lot of great days in sports. There's a lot of slow days, especially in the summer times with the dog days of summer where there's not a lot to talk about. But this is actually a phenomenal day. And it's the summertime. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I get to drag the Knicks for 3 hours. Oh, boy. This shit is funny to me. I tell you what, when we get back from the break, we'll switch gears a little bit, talk a little football. Vince Young says what your boy has been saying forever. Right, you don't want to miss that. Back in 3 minutes, the Doug Stewart Show.
Oh, that's like my sister, that's my best friend for real. Word to everything, there's nothing there to feel. Yeah, you, your vibes ain't different. See, you ain't really innocent. Now I'ma let it slide, but you should be careful what's real. I'm too experienced.